Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. Today we're going to look at one of the coolest sounds that there is for not just playing guitar, but for playing music in general. And if you learn how to use this sound, it will literally change your musical world as you know it. Now the sound that I'm talking about here is called arpeggios, and this sound is the coolest way that a melody can intricately track a group of chords, oftentimes without any need of the chords to even be there. In this lesson, we're going to learn a beautiful sounding arpeggio idea and how it can be applied across four different chord types. Then in the second half of this lesson over on my Patreon page, you'll get a bonus video where I'm going to show you how you can expand on these arpeggios that we'll cover here, taking them into use across the neck so that they can be applied in a completely different way that expands both on their sound and on their musical use. So let's get into all this by playing through the four fingerboard shapes of these arpeggios. Before we get started, I just want to let you in on how you can get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations. To donate and download your copy today. When it comes to learning about arpeggio patterns, one of the first things to understand is that arpeggios come directly from the chords of the key that you're playing in. And when we work out the most popular sounding arpeggios, we actually wind up with four main types. They are the major, minor, dominant, and augmented. Now, let's get started by learning shapes for each of these sounds. We're going to begin with a minor shape built off of an A here at the 7th fret 4th string. The arpeggio sounds like this. All right, so let's take a look at what's going on here. We're starting on the 7th fret 4th string. We have a slide on the 2nd string from 8 to 10, back to 8. And then we grab a 9th fret 3rd string, and then a 10th fret on 4th string, back to that root once more. Alright, so that's our minor sound for that first shape there off of A, and then we're going to move to F and get you a major sound. Check it out. Alright, so for the major sound, what we're going to be doing now is grabbing a 3rd fret F, and then we'll have a slide on the 2nd string from 5 to 6, come back to that 5th fret once more, and then get a 5th fret 3rd string and a 7th fret 4th string back into that root. Alright, so that's our coverage for major. And then the next coverage is going to be for dominant, and that's going to be set up here in the 5th fret position for G. And for this one, we're having that 5th fret G come in first on that 4th string, and then we're sliding on 2nd string from 6 to 8, coming back to 6 again. And then we'll have a 7th fret 3rd string, and then a 9th fret 4th string to take us back around to that root note once more. Alright, so that's our coverage for the dominant. And then our last one is going to be coverage for a really cool sounding chord. It's augmented. It's a really nice sound. So to do this one, what we're going to be doing is adding in some passing tones, because the E augmented really just has the notes of E, G sharp, and C in it. And what we're going to be doing is adding in some passing tones just to kind of round it out and have it match to the other sounds of those seventh qualities that we were just playing through. So we're going to start on that E. We're going to take a C here on first fret, second string, slide it up to a D on 3rd fret. Now the D's not in the shape, but it's going to be a passing note that'll take us back to a unison of that C that we just played on the 3rd string 5th fret. And then we'll have a B note, again a note that's not in the arpeggio, but it's going to be a passing tone. It's on 4th fret of the 3rd string. And then we'll add in a 6th fret G sharp. That is on the 4th string, and it is in the arpeggio too. And that's going to take us back to that E root. Alright, so that's a unique sound, a little bit different color for the augmented. But that covers all of those chords. Now, what we're going to be doing next is taking a short break, but when I come back, I'm going to apply all these chords here into a melody for you so you can get some practice and get them going in your playing. And then what we're going to do next in the Patreon lesson, the second half of the lesson here, is we're going to look at another totally different approach that's going to take triads and do an add-to arpeggio sound. And it's really going to drag the arpeggios like quite loud. laterally along the whole span of the guitar fingerboard. You're going to really enjoy that one. If you're not a member of my Patreon page, definitely go down there, go to patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio, and that's going to give you access with a $15 a month plan to all of the supplemental material for these lessons, handouts for PDF downloads, jam tracks, and also you're going to get a bonus video on top of that. It's really worth the $15 a month. You get a ton of extra stuff not related to what we do here on YouTube. So anyway, I'm going to take a short break, come back with that melody that I have for you for these chords, and then after that, I'll catch up with you next on Patreon. As we've discussed in many of our past guitar lessons that we've done, there's a huge value that comes out of the application of every musical concept that you're studying. And for that reason, what we're going to do next is take the arpeggio shapes that we've just practiced and apply those arpeggio patterns across a melodic phrase. Okay, so what we're going to be doing is just using the arpeggio shapes that we had from the first part of the lesson, and we're going to be playing the A minor, the F, and the G dominant two times through, and then we'll have an ending that wraps up off of the E augmented chord. So first of all, starting off on that shape that we've covered before for the A minor, we're on the 7th fret 4th string for the A root, and then we're sliding on 2nd string 8 to 10, bringing the 8th fret back once more, and then on the 3rd string we've got a 9th fret, and on the 4th string a 10th fret to take us back to the root once again. Just before we go over the new measure, we're just sort of pausing there off that 10th fret, jumping to the new chord on F, and that's the 3rd fret on that 4th string. And then we're going to move forward on the 2nd string, 5 to 6, back to the 5, 3rd string 5th fret, and 4th string 7th fret, taking us back to the root once again. So play that two times. And then we're going to go into the G chord next. So we're going to do a slide after we play the 5th fret 4th string root of G. We're going to do a slide on 2nd string 6 to 8. Bring back the 6th fret once more, 7th fret on 3rd string comes in, and then we got a 9th fret on 4th string to take us back to that root note of the chord. So we do that two times on that one. And then what's going to happen next is we're going to move in on that augmented, that E augmented. So we're going to hit the E note, and then we're going to go on 2nd string, that's on 4th string of course, we're going to go on 2nd string, slide 1st fret to 3rd fret, and then we'll bring in a 5th fret on 3rd string with the 4th fret. Then on the 4th string, we'll have a 6th fret. We're going to go down, hit the root, hit the open string, and then go to the 5th string, and we'll have 3rd fret and 2nd fret. Kind of like a little bit of a turnaround phrase there, you know? C, B on 5th string, 3rd fret and 2nd fret 5th string. And then basically that just sort of pulls it back to the top. The augmented chord, you can tell it really has a lot of strong pull to take us back to that root that we're dealing with, which is the A minor. So overall, there's your nice arpeggio phrase that you can mess around with, and it's just using and applying everything that we had practiced in the first part of the lesson. So anyway, that wraps up everything here to do with the YouTube video, and I hope to see you next on Patreon, where I'm going to introduce you to a brand new sound where we're going to take some triads and we're going to go through them with the add two on it. That's the sound that you get out of it. It's a very cool sound. I've got some nice arpeggios to show you. We're going to go through another melodic statement idea. And then, plus, if you're a Patreon member, you're going to get all the tab and everything for that intro piece that you heard me play at the start of the YouTube lesson here. So I hope to see you next on Patreon. And otherwise, work on all these great sounding arpeggios. They're really a beautiful sound, and they just have such an interesting connection to these underlying chords that we have. They're so strong that you almost don't even need those chords in the background. So have fun with this stuff. It's really cool to work on. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you're going to get to watch a bonus video where I'm going to show you how you can expand on these arpeggio shapes that we've covered here in this YouTube lesson and take them into use across the neck so that they can be applied in a completely different way that expands both on their sound and in their musical end use. Plus, if you're a Patreon member, along with the bonus video, you'll get a jam track and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips as well as explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon, become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members' discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.